you see a lot of very powerful spinners up to full speed around the arena?
Yeah, I can, my robot is particularly very sort of bland and difficult to actually spot in the arena. But I think I can see it, and it's still moving at the moment, so that's good.
You've got some spinning weapons, you've got axes, you've got crushing mechanisms. Really fantastic designs. And what are these weighing in? About 13.5 kilos?
Just about 13.6 to be accurate, but yeah, 13.5 kilos. And you try not to balance power and armour, and try to get a weapon that's reasonably effective against all the other types of robots in there. I really personally like the grabbers and the crushers, I think they're great fun. And also the washing robot with big wheels that's sort of similar to Gogo, but I think it might stop.
I will say, for those that are a fan of Crusher, the fighting dust in there, it is still surviving. Still going somehow, it's still in that arena working.
It's amazing it hasn't actually fallen over, really, but after saying that, it probably will now.
Seems like a few of the robots have gotten stuck underneath the flipper.
That happens quite often, it hangs to me quite often as well, so, yeah.
Oh. Now this is where things get a bit interesting. We activate the pitch, and you'll be surprised at how many you can end up in that very soon.
Yeah, for me, actually, whenever I'm driving one of the featherweights, I say to myself, don't go near the pit, don't go near the pit. And always I'm thinking I'm not going near the pit.
You try and stay to the right
of
it, really. Yeah, it's inevitable, really. Now, there's a lot of robots that seem to have stopped working now, or have just been launched across the arena, as you just saw there. Yeah. So we're getting down to the crucial time where there are points to be bound for the team.
Yeah, the judges are now looking. And they'll be seeing what's moving and what isn't. How well they're doing.
That was the sound of a devastated audience as the tractor eventually tumbles over.
The Empire fell.
So we're down to one robot there looks considerably bigger than the other. Is that just the choice of where they put the weight distribution then?
Yeah, I think that one uses a lot of plastic similar to my robot, and so they can afford to make the robot bigger. A lot of them are made out of very, very hard steel, and they tend to be the smaller ones. But so far so good, it's going very well.
We're into the final 10 seconds. Who's going to get that victory?
Do you know what? I could be wrong, but...
Let's give it up for the featherweight! Now,
I could be wrong, but I think...